how I helped this Lionel Alco with no reverse unit boldly go where it had never gone before. Reverse. Adding reverse to non-reversing locomotives on this episode of Toy Train Tips and Tricks. Hello again, this is Mike with Toy Train Tips and Tricks. And here we have this Lionel number 1055 Alco FA. This was a bottom of the barrel locomotive when it came out with no special features, no horn, only a headlight, and no reversing mechanism. This locomotive was designed to go forward only, and yet here you see it is going in both forward and reverse. Now, I could have done this by adding an aftermarket reverse unit, whether it be the original electromechanical or a new electronic type version, and that would have run me between $30 and $60 depending on the model. But instead, being cheap, I did this modification using an electrical component that cost about $5. Here's how we did it. Okay, so let's take a look at our Lionel FA motor here. So we have this goes to the center rail. Our power comes through this wire over here to this brush where it goes through the commutator face to the armature. Through the coiled windings in there, we come out here on this brush and we go here and this wire's come detached, but that's supposed to be attached right there. This goes to one side of the field coil and then the other side of the field coil comes right out here, joins in and through this screw, everything is grounded, common, to the locomotive frame, which is then connected to the outside wheels to the outside rails. As it sits here, this motor is not meant to be reversed. There is no reversing mechanism. The motor will only turn in one direction. If I want to change the direction, I would have to change the orientation of the brushes here with the field. So I could take and move, switch these two wires here on the brushes so it would come into this side, go through and out this side to the field, and that would make the motor spin in the opposite direction. So obviously, anytime that we're switching, we don't want to take the motor apart and keep switching these wires back and forth. So traditionally, the way a Lionel locomotive would reverse would be with some sort of a reversing unit, either the original electromechanical E-unit or the more modern electronic E-unit. Essentially, what it does is changes the orientation of these brushes versus the field. So rather than physically changing the wiring connections from one brush to the other brush, it does so electronically, switching whether the power is going through this one first, then this one, or vice versa. And that type of reversing unit works regardless of whether you're using AC power or DC power. But what if you don't have a reversing unit? Well, you can either add one, you can purchase one and wire it in. And those will generally run you, depending on the model, $40 to $60, sometimes higher. But if I'm running my locomotive on DC current instead of AC current, instead of using an electronic reverse unit that, again, is going to be between $40 and $60 on average, I can buy a bridge rectifier, generally for less than $5 for the specifications that we need. And this can get the job done if we know how to wire it in. The trick to reversing with a bridge rectifier and DC current is electrically separating the two halves, the field winding from the armature, so that one is more or less permanently set to one polarity, whereas the other one becomes changeable. The changing polarity part happens either by switching the direction control on your standard DC power pack or by changing the polarity on your AC to DC converter like we built in our previous episode. It doesn't matter which side of the circuit we make permanent, whether it's the field or the armature. Choose whichever one is easiest to access, depending on the layout of your particular motor. In this case, I'm going to make the field windings the permanent polarity, and then the transformer will be able to change the polarity of the armature. By doing this, when the field and the armature are the same polarity, the motor will spin one direction. When it is the opposite polarity, it will spin the opposite direction, therefore giving us forward and reverse. So looking at our bridge rectifier now, this is an old one I pulled out of another project, so it's marked up a little bit, but we have our four leads here, and one will be marked with a plus sign, which this one used to have a plus sign right here, and then this indicates AC current. So this was our DC positive, and that makes this our DC negative. This one and this one, the polarity doesn't matter. So since we have DC power coming in already, what will happen is if the polarity is one direction, it will force only that one direction of the current to go. If it's the opposite, it'll force the other side to go. We are going to take our plus and our minus, which I've wired with yellow and red here, and we are going to attach that to the two ends of our field coil. Does it matter which one? No, not really. And then we are going to take my two other leads, which I have black here, and we are going to attach one to the other end of the brush. We have disconnected this wire here. This one is going to go to the DC part of the bridge rectifier. This is going to go to the, shall we say, AC part of the bridge rectifier. Then we're going to disconnect this connection here. This wire, instead of going to this, will instead go here on the bridge rectifier. And then we will attach this black screw here, this grounding screw, we'll get the other black wire. Again, does it matter which black wire goes where? No. Okay, so let's take a look at my connections here. We have our center rail power going just as it was before to this brush along with the headlight. Then on this side, again, we split this connection. We have our black wire from our bridge rectifier going to the brush, whereas the field coil wire that used to be attached here now runs to this red wire from my bridge rectifier. Then the other side of the field coil goes to the yellow wire on my bridge rectifier. So this was DC plus. This is DC minus. I could switch plus and minus. That would just change, you know, the direction based on any particular switch. But for our purpose with one locomotive, doesn't matter which one is which. And then the last connection right here, my other black wire from the bridge rectifier, comes in right here to this grounding post and grounds the whole circuit to the locomotive frame and the outside rails. All right, so I've wired it up to my DC power pack here on my workbench. We're going to give it a smoke test, and we're going to see, can we make these wheels turn in opposite directions for the first time ever? Let's try one direction. That would be forward, off, and that would be reverse. So there we have it. By changing the DC polarity, we are changing the direction of the locomotive using only a bridge rectifier. Let's put it on the layout. Now, there are a few things you should keep in mind. First, by doing this conversion, you are essentially making the motor behave as a DC motor, and it will not operate properly on AC current unless you return the wiring to its original configuration. However, if you have a locomotive with no reverse or one with a dead reverse unit that you don't wish to replace, and you're willing to use DC current on your layout at least once in a while, this method can easily and inexpensively add life to an otherwise limited locomotive. Check the video description for links to inexpensive rectifiers that are rated for this project, and click on the link in the upper right-hand corner to watch the previous episode about the advantages and disadvantages of DC current for your layout and how to build an AC to DC converter. Lastly, I ask, please don't fill up the comments asking for specific wiring diagrams for various different locomotives. Lionel and Marx made many locomotives. They're all configured differently, and I simply don't have the time and resources to provide diagrams for every single one of them. Just inspect your motor wiring and identify the field coil and the brush plate and determine which would be the easiest way to wire your rectifier for your motor. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it, and if so, please like it, share it, subscribe, and tell your friends and neighbors. Keep the trains running in both directions, and I'll catch you next time on Toy Train Tips and Tricks.